Hello everyone, good morning students. Dear students, in previous class we take and discuss a very important chapter of your syllabus, which is triangle. And in that class we are going to discuss about so many important questions related to triangles. Now in that class we also take and solve some important question of your NCERT exercise based on triangles. So let's see, your first question is, this is very important question of your syllabus of your NCERT book. Your question: in the given figure, AC is equal to AE, AB is equal to AD, and angle BAD is equal to angle EAC. Show that BC is equal to DE. Show that what? BC is equal to D, and your figure is, is A, B, C, this is D, this is E, this, and in that figure the side AB is equal to AD and AC is equal to what? A. We have to show that BC is equal to DA. Okay. BC is equal to DA. Dear student, this is one of the most important question of your NCERT exercise. Okay. So now let's see what is the process to solve that question. Let's see its solution. First of all, let's see, dear student. We have AC is equal to AE and AB is equal to what? AD, okay? And angle BAD is equal to angle EAC. Now look here. Here angle BAD, that angle is equal to EAC, that angle. But we have to show that side BC, that side BC is equal to D. Means to prove what? To prove BC is equal to DE, na? Okay. Now let's see. To proving that result, means BC is equal to DE, we take two triangle as ABC and triangle EAD or ADE. Okay, so in that way, first of all, that angle, then let's see, that angle is common to both the triangle. Okay, so angle DAC is common in both the triangle, which we required. Now we adding angle DAC both side of, we take equation number 1. Now we adding angle DAC. Now we adding angle DAC to both side of equation 1. We get, okay. Now we adding angle DAC to both side of equation first. So we get what? Let's see, angle BAD plus angle DAC is equal to angle EAC plus angle DAC. Okay. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी एड एंगल डी ए सी टू बोथ साइड ऑफ इक्वेशन वन. दिस इज डी ए सी डी ए. नाउ तो लेट्स सी फ्रॉम फिगर. तो एंगल बी ए डी प्लस एंगल डी ए सी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? एंगल बी ए सी ना. दस फ्रॉम फिगर, दस फ्रॉम फिगर द सम ऑफ दीज टू एंगल्स इज इक्वल टू एंगल बी ए सी. बी ए सी इज इक्वल टू नाउ एंगल ई ए सी प्लस एंगल डी ए सी. डी ए सी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? एंगल ई ए डी. ओके, मीन्स सम ऑफ दीज टू एंगल्स इज इक्वल टू एंगल ई ए डी ना. यस, सो हियर वी राइट एंगल ई ए डी. दैट इज इक्वेशन, टेक इक्वेशन नंबर टू. ओके, तो इन दिस वे डियर फ्रेंड्स वी फॉर्म अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन एंगल्स. मीन्स एंगल बी ए सी इज इक्वल टू एंगल ई ए डी. ओके, नाउ डियर फ्रेंड वी हैव टू शो दैट बी सी इज इक्वल टू डी. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी टेक ट्राइंगल ए बी सी एंड ई डी ए और डी ई ए. ओके, नाउ वी टेक ट्राइंगल ए बी सी एंड ट्राइंगल ई सी, नो ई डी ए. We have, let's see, in these two triangle, let's see, we take triangle A, B, C and triangle AED. So we have what? Let's see, from figure ABA. A D E, A D. Let's see. We take triangle A. This is B, na? A B C and A D E. Let's see. So we have the result A C is equal to A. Let's see here. A C is equal to A. This is given. A C is equal to A. This is given. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी नेक्स्ट वन. हियर ए बी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? ए डी. दिस इज आल्सो गिवन. ए बी इज इक्वल टू ए डी. दिस इज आल्सो गिवन ना. यस, वन थिंग इज दैट कि ए सी इज इक्वल टू ए. ओके, इट इज गिवन. Now we have to show that angle BAC is equal to, means BAC, that angle is equal to angle EAD. Okay, BAC is equal to angle EAD and AB is equal to AD. This is also given. AB is equal to what? AD. This is given. This is right from equation 2. From equation 2. Thus, by SAS congruence rule, thus, by side angle side, congruence rule, triangle ABC is congruence to triangle ADE. Thus, by CPCT, means that what? Corresponding parts of congruent triangle must be equal to each other. So in this way, dear students, we have BC is equal to DA. BC is equal to DA. Hence proved. Dear student, this is one of the most important question of your syllabus. So please, dear student, do more and more practices of that type of question. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. So this is very important question. So please, let's see once more time that question. This is very important question, na? So here, this is a given figure, and just a minute. Let's see, this is a given figure, and in that figure we have that side AC is equal to A and AB is equal to AD. Now, dear students, we have to show and also a relation between given as angle BAD is equal to angle EAD, AESE. Now, we have to show that BC is equal to what? D. Dear students, after observing the given figure, we conclude that ki side BC and side DE included in the triangles ABC and triangle ADE. Now, first of all, we have to show that the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADE. Okay. Now, for that, we have a very important relation, angle BAD is equal to angle EAC, but we observing that that angle BAC and angle EAD is common in both the triangles. So for that, we adding angle DAC both side of equation 1. We take the given relation as equation 1. Now we add angle BDAC into both side of equation 1. So we get this result. After that, according to figure, angle BAD plus angle DAC is equal to angle BAC and is equal to angle EAC and angle DAC is equal to angle EAD. So we form equation 2. Now we take triangle ABC and triangle ADE. So we have AC is equal to AE, which is given in our question now. And angle BAC is equal to angle EAD, we have to show it, and AB is equal to AD. Okay, so in this way, by side angles and triangle congruence criterion, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADE. So by CPCT, BC is equal to DE. So this is the required solution of the given questions. Okay, Jason, so please, Jason, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on this talk. This is very important question. So in the same process, you can solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise. Okay, so here one CPCT, you know that very well, ki corresponding parts of congruent triangle must be equal to each other, means BC is equal to DE, AB is equal to AD, as well as AC is equal to AE also. And angle ABC is equal to angle ADE, angle BCA is equal to angle DEA, and angle BAC is equal to angle DAE. So that is the concept of that. Now we take solve some other important question. In the given figure, PS is equal to QR, PS is equal to QR, and angle SPQ and angle SPQ is equal to angle RQP. Okay, prove that triangle PQS is congruent to triangle QPR, triangle QPR, comma PR is equal to 2S and angle QPR is equal to angle PQS. This is the question here, and your figure is this is P Q R S and this is P R and Q S. Okay. Now look, here we have to show that triangle PQS, we take that angle PQS and angle QPR, where is QPR? QPR, okay. We have to show that triangle PQS is congruent to triangle PQPR, okay, this is your question. Now let's see its solution. This way in triangle, we take both the thing now. We take triangle PQS and triangle QPR. We take two triangles now, because we have to show that both the triangles are congruent to each other. So first of all, we take triangle PQS and triangle PR. Let's see. Angle PQS. PQS. Let's see. PQS. That is PQS. And QPR. Let's see. This is QPR. We take that triangles. Okay. That. Now, in angle PQS, PQS and QPR, we have what? We have its side PS is equal to QR is given that. Which side? PS is equal to QR. This is PS is equal to what? QR. PS is equal to QR. This is what? This is given in our question. And second one thing is that what? Triangle SPQ. Let's see. SPQ, that angle SPQ is same as given as angle RQP, angle RQP, this is also what given. Okay, and let's see in both the triangle PQS and QPR, QPS and QPR, one side is common, which is PQ. So that side PQ is common in both the triangles now. So that is PQ is equal to PQ, this is common side. Thus by which congruence criterion, dear students? Thus by side angle side. Thus by SAS congruence rule, triangle PQS is congruence to triangle QPR. Thus by CBCT, this is proved first part, okay?
one result is proved. Now by CP, CT, corresponding part of congruent triangles must be equal to each other. So by CP, CT, we have what we have? Let's see. PR is equal to QS. PR is equal to Q because of these are the corresponding parts, and CP, CT means in any triangle which are congruent to each other, then the congruent part of corresponding angles are parts of congruent triangles are equal to. So this is another proof. And next one, angle, let's see, QPR, and also angle QPR is equal to angle PQS. These are also by CBCT, hence proof. Dear student, this is the process to solve that type of question. So please, dear student, do more and more and more practices of that type of question. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Now, we take and solve some other important questions of your NCERT. Let's see. We can solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise. In right triangle ABC, this is very important question, dear students. This is very important question. In right triangle ABC, right angle at C. Right angle at C. Okay. M is the midpoint on the hypotenuse AB. C is joined to M and produce to a point D, and produce to point D, okay, such that DM is equal to CM. Point D is joined to point P. Point D is joined to point B. Okay. Point B. Show that first. Triangle AMC is congruent to triangle PMD. BFD. Second one, angle BBC is equal to BBC is equal to angle ACB. Third one is what? Third one, angle and triangle BBC congruence to triangle ACB. Now let's see its solution. Now first of all, we draw the figure. Here ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle and a right angle at C, and M is the midpoint on the hypotenuse AB. This is your midpoint M, and we join CM and produce to D. We join CM and produce to D, and D join to B. Okay. Now, so in this way, So that side is equal to that side because of m is the midpoint of this. Now let us take its proof. So now the solution, now we take first part. Now in triangle AMC and triangle BMD, we have what we have, let's see. AMC and BMD. This is CM is equal to BM. It is clear, everyone? Or AM is equal to BM also, because of this is the midpoint of this. So AM is equal to BM. Okay. Angle AMC is equal to angle BMD. These are the vertically opposite angle. These are the vertically opposite angles. And also MC is equal to DM. MC is equal to DM. This is what? This is given in field from figure. This is also from figure. Thus, by which congruent criterion, dear students? Side angle side. Okay. Thus, by SAS congruence rule, we have triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. Hence proof. Okay. So this is the process, dear friend. To solve that type of question, so please do more and more practices of that type of question. After that, you can prove all the question of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay. So now we have to show the triangle BBC congruence to triangle ACB. Now we take these two triangles. Let's see. Now, in triangle DBC and triangle ACB, we have, first of all, we have to show that it is congruent to each other. So in that, both the triangles, if we take as DB, let's see, DB is equal to what? AC, na? Because of both the triangle A, yes, there. Here, by this relation, AC is equal to BD. AC is equal to BD. By the first relation, because we have to show that triangle AMC is equal to BMD. So BD is equal to AC by CBCD, na? BD is equal to AC. So in both the triangle, so DB is equal to AC. From first result. Okay? DB is equal to AC. And angle, you know, DBC is equal to angle ACB. ACB is equal to what? 90 degree. And second one, BC is equal to BCCB. BC is common in both the triangle. BC is equal to CB. Thus, by SAS congruence rule, triangle BBC congruent to triangle ACB. Hence proof. And by CPCT, we have to prove that result also. By CPCT, let's see corresponding congruent part of corresponding triangles are equal. Means triangle, we can write angle DBC is equal to triangle ACB. Hence proof. Okay, so this is the process to solve that type of question. Okay, so now we take and solve some other important question of your syllabus. Now your question is, thus dear students, in this way, in today class, we take and solve some important questions related to your NCERT exercise based on triangles. Okay, now
Dear students, in next class we take and solve some other important questions of your NCERT exercise based on related to the chapter triangles, and in next class we complete the chapter triangles. Okay, dear students, now thanks to all.